Christian, and you're tuned into The Edge, the voice of independent artists. But today we're honoring Martin Luther King, and we're out on the steps of the Lincoln Memorial. And behind, well, you can't see it, behind you is the actual Lincoln Memorial. So we're gonna take a look at that. You can see that this is where Martin Luther King actually delivered the famous speech, I Have a Dream. Now, it's amazing just to be here. In a little bit, we're gonna go up and we're gonna actually see the monument. We're gonna look at the actual place where he stood, because they actually have a place like right on the foot of the monument, which is monumental, where he actually gave the speech. And we'll talk more about that when we get up there. And
happy birthday, Martin.
Hey, everybody. This is Christian. I'm back. And I'm here with one of the tourists. You're a tourist, right?
Yeah, I live here.
They're out visiting the MLK, the Lincoln Memorial, where the MLK speech was given. So can you just tell me, what do you think, or what it's like to be here to actually see where the speech was taken and at the foot of the monument?
Well, some of the things that come to mind is basically thinking about, on one hand, you see, you know, initially Abraham Lincoln and bringing freedom for everyone, but then the difference between the more ethereal vision and idea of freedom for everybody, but then the reality of it when Martin Luther King gave his speech and was trying to bring about what America claimed to stand for, between the actual of what was actually occurring and the oppression that was going on and the unfairness and injustice. And so bringing to light, here's the vision of what we want to believe America is and what America can be and should be, between the actual and, you know, the greatness of the moment of helping to bring America a little bit closer to the ideal, where, well, we're still not there, obviously we're far better off than where we were before the Civil Rights Movement and Martin Luther King when he gave the speech, that momentous event.
Perfect. You took the words right out of my mouth. I don't know what more to say after that. I was going to ask, do you think that we've actually come to a place now where we can actually say his dream has been realized?
No. I mean, we're definitely better off than we were 50, 60, 70 years ago, but there's still plenty of instances of intolerance and prejudice, and in, you know, some cases outright racism, where, and not to mention the fact of sexism and homophobia, and, you know, discrimination still exists. We're better, but we've still got a ways to go, and that's something that I think that's important that people keep in mind, and to not just think, oh, everything's better, we can just pretend like problem solved, but to actually keep trying to bring us about to the realization of the vision that he had.
Before we go, can you just look to the camera and tell, say whatever it is that you're feeling right now to America out there, and just to have them think about where we need to go in the direction to actually achieve this dream that he, you know, really stood here for. He gave that speech to the thing.
Right, and basically I think is that we need to keep in mind that vision and to think about all the instances where people are treated unfairly, unjustly, and they are treated differently, not because of what they do or if they have beliefs that are hateful, but for the exact opposite reason. To keep in mind that prejudice is still there, and not only to fight against it in others, but to look internally and make sure that those feelings and thoughts aren't held internally. Because, of course, you know, that's where change really starts.
I just want to say thank you for allowing me the opportunity to get your point of view perspective from this standpoint. thank you so much
absolutely for
tuning in. Everybody, stay tuned for some more point of views and perspectives from other tourists and guests out here as we continue to get those on MLK Birthday.
Happy birthday, Martin Luther King Jr.
Happy birthday, Martin Luther King. Alright, y'all, so after a lot of questioning to a lot of different people, I was able to only get one person to give their point of view, but yet and still, that was a really good point of view that you just saw. He gave some really great answers, and it is so true that even today in 2011, we still haven't quite accomplished the dream that was set out when Martin Luther King stood here to give that speech all those years ago. However, we are really coming really, really close. And once again, it's just an honor to stand here and be at the foot of the memorial and to stand where he stood and gave the speech and to see the beautiful scenery that he saw with all those many faces and all those people standing out in the audience looking at him give the speech. And then to be here amongst all these different nationalities and cultures and come here every single day to share their time and their love here at the Lincoln Memorial. It's really awe-inspiring, and at the same time, it's kind of sad. But we honor Martin Luther King for the man that he was and the things that he's done, and we're looking forward to the future, and hopefully we can see a difference and a change in America the next couple of years and years to come. Thanks for watching. Thanks for tuning in, y'all. This has been The Edge. It's not as funny as always. I know you would love for it to be, but hell, it's my show. I can do what I want. So look, in remembrance of Martin Luther King, we're going to get out of here, y'all. These are some pictures and collages of him and his life and his family. Enjoy, much love, and let's remember that this day is really sacred and special. Honor this man, his memory, and never let it die. Much love. I'm out.
Rescue me. When I close my eyes, I dream of you.